Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Jack, and welcome back to another video. And before getting started on the nitty-gritty on the topic of this commentary, the first game you're going to get to see is just me completely stomping in the lobby in a free-for-all game to where the game just decides to throw me a bone, and then the second game is one of very many games to where it's an absolute struggle. But this time I come out on top, especially against the guy that made it to second place, who was winning every single game previously. And I certainly don't mind a challenge, and it even got to the point to where in one of the games, because it seemed like I was the only one that was able to kill him consistently, that he decided to shoot my body. It actually happened during stream last night. I streamed this game for 5 hours playing free-for-all, and then around the second half or so of the stream, I just decided to keep on using the AK-74U, because in this game I quickly realized that there are certain weapons that, even though they're DLC weapons or battle pass weapons, whatever the hell you call them, or to where you can unlock them by grinding, that some of them are just not very good, which I learned the hard way trying to level them up, and then I just said, screw it, AK-74U, here we go. And this is actually Scump's class, because except it's got all five slots filled up, because there's no gentleman's agreement here in pubs. Definitely, there's no gentleman at all, actually. Very, very few. So, but anyway, that's what the two gameplays are. So, first one, super easy. Second one, it's down to the wire. So, I hope you guys enjoy that. But anyway, let's get into the nitty-gritty, shall we? Now, there is no doubt in the Call of Duty community at this point. I think everybody, if not the majority of the Call of Duty community, will actually agree with me when I say that we are in some pretty dark times when it comes to Call of Duty, right? So, everything from the amount of views on Twitch to the amount of views in the pro scene and all that kind of stuff, we've got all sorts of shit going on. There's been people saying that hacks are now available on console, like aimbotting and wall hacking, like they are on PC. So it's gone beyond Cronus Max and all that other shit now. You got all that shit coming now to Warzone on PC, on console as well as on PC. Viewership numbers are down. A lot of YouTubers' numbers are down and all that kind of stuff, both big and small alike. I mean, the people are not very fond of the game. And with all of this going on, guys, I've got proof behind this, because history does tend to repeat itself, and when you put it together, it just makes sense. We are about to enter with Call of Duty Vanguard, or Call of Duty World War II Vanguard, Slipstream, whatever the hell it's going to end up being called. We are actually, I think, going to be in the darkest times of Call of Duty perhaps ever, or at the very least since Infinite Warfare. Now, as you guys know, it's not a secret that I am a very small YouTuber. As a matter of fact, I'm smaller than I've pretty much ever been, ever since, you know, hitting 1,000 or more subscribers or whatnot. And that's cool. A lot of people don't like watching this game. And then there's the other things, the inconsistencies and all that kind of stuff, you name it. But I'm a small fry, and I've got absolutely no problem with that. I'm actually enjoying posting YouTube now than I have over the last couple of years, believe it or not. But yet on streams, and sometimes in the comment section, and sometimes even on Twitter, I got people telling me that they are not looking forward to the World War II setting, or they don't like the World War II setting. Now, we all know that the World War II setting is pretty much, how do we put this? It is, it's basically a coat of paint. It's basically how the game looks, but the game could still play amazing. But a lot of people, in terms of the game, where the game takes place and all that kind of stuff, and even with the campaign, because there are people out there that love campaign, love zombies and all that kind of stuff, they really care about how the game looks and what setting the game takes place in, right? Now, if I can just take you back to 2016, when they finally officially revealed the trailer for Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, which, by the way, I fully say this, that the game Infinite Warfare, from a multiplayer gameplay standpoint, is getting way more hate than it deserves. And I played a few hours of the campaign, and the campaign looks solid as well. As a matter of fact, a lot of fans that have played the campaign that I personally have talked to, whether it's on Twitter, on stream, or in the comment section, will actually tell me that the campaign was solid as a motherfucker. And what I've played of it is, it absolutely is. And as a matter of fact, sometime in the future, I might go back and play it, because I actually enjoyed it. But again, you know, I'm mostly a multiplayer guy. There's a whole bunch of new stuff going on. But anyway, but what happened when they revealed the trailer to Call of Duty Infinite Warfare? It was one of the most disliked videos in YouTube history, and the game itself got a shit ton of hate. Like, even before the game came out and anybody got a chance to try it and all that kind of stuff. And the thing is, the timing was off because everybody had 2 years of advanced movement. We had Advanced Warfare, and then after Advanced Warfare, we had Black Ops 3. So everybody was ready to go back to boots on the ground. They've had enough of the advanced movement. It's like, okay, let's return to form and all that kind of stuff. And when Infinite Warfare obviously revealed that it wasn't going to do that, the game was pretty much all but dead on arrival. Some people will say that it was actually dead on arrival, which I could totally understand. All because people did not like A, the setting, and obviously B, which had to do with its gameplay, the advanced movement. Now, with Vanguard, I will say that, you know, most people should be happy because we won't be having advanced movement in that. Although I think a lot, I've also seen this on Twitter, like some people actually kind of miss the advanced movement, but I don't think that's the majority. I think a lot of people prefer, most Call of Duty players, I think, prefer boots on the ground to advanced movement. And I think if they were to do advanced movement again, they could definitely, in my opinion, I think they can do ways to where it won't be as excessive, but yet at the same time add a layer of skill to it. But we all know how they want how they approach skill at this point, because Activision likes to put their hands in the middle, likes to put their nose in the middle and say, you can't do that, because our noobs are going to get absolutely destroyed by skilled players. So they add in things like thick skill-based matchmaking, EOMM, engagement optimization matchmaking, which, by the way, I truly believe is why the spawn system is so fucked, especially if you're a devoted free-for-all player like I am. I mean, the spawn system is just made to screw over players. I mean, that's why you catch a lot of people just sitting in spawn with their sights aimed down, because they know if they get killed, they're going to get spawned between two guys shooting at each other or somewhere in the open to where they have no choice but to get shot and die again until they get a decent spawn. So, and it's proof, because, I mean, why not copy and paste the spawns that were in Black Ops 2 on those Black Ops 2 maps? The spawns were just fine in Black Ops 2, but nope, can't do that. But you guys know how it goes. So you put everything together, we're in some pretty dark times, and for a whole bunch of different reasons. So a lot of people are not ready, from what they tell me, and I'm a small guy, okay? I'm a nobody here. So they tell me they are not looking forward to, and they don't like the World War II setting, the World War II era. Now, granted, it's not like to where it's going to have an effect on the gameplay, at least I hope not, because, first of all, we're going to be using the Modern Warfare 2019 engine, according to leaks and rumors and everything that we've heard so far, right? So, and it's only a matter of time, especially right now, we're like approaching the middle of July, and we still haven't received any official leaks of the gameplay. I mean, we've heard people talking about it, but not much, if at all. Or we know that somebody's seen leaked gameplay, but I don't know if they mentioned anything or not or whatnot, but we still haven't seen anything yet, and we're almost in the middle of July. So, you know, we're about, what, 5 months away from release or something like that? And we still haven't seen anything. There hasn't been any official reveals. So I personally think it's right around the corner to where we're finally going to get to hear and see something, whether it's official or unofficial. But just the fact that the game is going to take place in World War II is already putting a sour taste in people's mouths. Now, the game itself, from a campaign standpoint, could be absolutely terrific. Especially since a lot of fans love the campaign in Call of Duty. So casuals obviously are the ones that are at the forefront. And if you take campaign away from them, it doesn't end up very well. So campaign, I think, is probably going to be solid, especially the rumors that they're talking about taking place in the direction about the darker things that happened in World War II or whatnot, or making that up or something like that, or putting a twist on it. And then obviously there's rumors saying that Treyarch is always going to be doing zombies for every Call of Duty game from now on. I mean, I don't know how that's going to happen, but whatever. But obviously with the multiplayer, I mean, if it's the same group that was in charge of Sledgehammer Games after Condrey and Schofield left, that had the biggest overhaul in the multiplayer in Call of Duty history at that time, and possibly even till now to this day, I think in that aspect we're in good hands. But going back to reality, you can't ignore the fact that Activision just loves to put their greedy little noses into everything and likes to adjust everything. And the problem is that they overdo it. I think, like, a part of me wants to think that, like, well, actually, no. The devs have good intentions. Activision only cares about the money. So the devs can only do so much. So it's going to be very interesting to see what happens in the coming days, weeks, or months in terms of the information that we get and the reveals. but just the fact that a lot of people are not looking forward to the World War II setting, not just because of what they told me, but also I've seen other people's videos and stuff like that. They're not crazy about it. They don't want it. So is it going to do, are we going to have a repeat of what happened with Infinite Warfare to where the game will be dead on arrival? And some people are saying that even if the setting was different, the game would be DOA because of all the rumors that are happening. I don't know. We will see what happens, but as I'm running out of time in this video, so let me know down in the comments section of this video, guys. What do you think? And of course, just to put some more proof in the pudding, are you guys ready for the World War II setting, or do you not give a damn about the coat of paint that Call of Duty is going to offer us this time? So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the footage in the background. Thank you for all those that have been coming to stream. It makes the biggest difference when I have company and I have somebody to talk to while streaming. It makes it that much more fun. It's why I do it in the first place. And that's all I got for this one, guys. So let me know down in the comment section below. Hope you enjoyed it. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.